نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد.
Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in another hadith that when husband and wife meet during their intimate relationship and before beginning the intimate relationship, if this dua was recited, Bismillah, Allahumma jannibna shaitan wa jannibish shaitana ma razaqtana. Bismillah, in the name of Allah. Allahumma jannibna shaitan, O Allah, save both of us from shaitan. Because during that moment, a person may do things which is impermissible in Islam. Overcome by desire for pleasure. Allahumma jannibna shaitan. O Allah, save us from shaitan. Do not let shaitan overpower us. وَجَنِّبِ الشَّيْطَانَ مَا رَزَقْتَنَا. O Allah, save that child from shaitan that you will grant us. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that if this dua is recited before cohabitation, then it is guarantee from our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَمْ يَذُرَّهُ shaitan, will not be able to harm that child. If as a result of that meeting, the child is conceived, and then the child is delivered, then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that it is guaranteed, لَمْ يَذُرَّهُ فَإِذَا قُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمَا وَلَدْ لَمْ يَذُرَّهُ. Shaitan will not be able to harm that child. The commentators of hadith explaining this hadith have said that if this dua is recited before cohabitation and as a result of that cohabitation a child is conceived and then after 9 months it is delivered, then that child will not be able to lose iman. That child will definitely die with iman. All those people who have an average understanding of deen, what is the greatest fear for you and me? The greatest fear is our final moments. Final moments. And here Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is guaranteeing. Now what do the parents have to do? All they have to do is remember to recite this dua. Every time they meet. And their children's future of the hereafter is secured. Shaitan will not be able to snatch their iman. Shaitan will not be able to deviate that child from iman.